So, let me start this off by saying that I'm not willing to disclose exactly where the events of this sighting took place, but I can say that I live in the US. The town I live in is not densely populated, but it's not a rural countryside either. Just a nice, peaceful urban town. There's only one thing that's a little special about my town, and that's the rain. We get a lot of rain, and I mean a lot. About 3 or 4 times a year, we get a rainstorm so bad that my town had to implement special drains and flood prevention systems just so there wouldn't be disasters. The rain is so bad during these storms that you can't even see more than a few feet in front of you, so it makes driving or traveling anywhere practically impossible. Our town has nicknamed these types of storms we get a few times a year as mega rainstorms, or MRS for short. The news is always warning about the next MRS weeks in advance. The police and fire department strongly advise the entire town to stay in their homes and don't dare to come out until the storm is over. I've lived here all my life, and I would always ask my parents about the storms. They told me to never go out in them, that it's too dangerous. So back when I was a kid, I would always ignore the storm and stay inside to play games. There was no point looking out the window at it, because the rain was so dense that visibility was terrible. I'm 21 now, and I've never even once dared to leave the house during a MRS, but that changed yesterday. Yesterday was a mega rainstorm, and it started around 5 p.m. I was already inside and watching TV, when at about 5:43 p.m., I got a text from my best friend Sean. He said he was caught out in the storm driving home, and he couldn't see anything. He ended up running into a telephone pole, and his car was stuck. He called the police, but they told him that they couldn't respond in this storm. So he was asking if I could come by to help him and take him back to my place until the storm was over. I didn't really want to go out in the middle of a storm, but Sean always had my back when I needed him, so I decided to go help. Sean told me what street he was on, and it was only about 10 blocks away, so I decided it would be best not to drive. With no visibility, it actually might be better for me to walk so I wouldn't get into an accident. I put on my rain boots and grabbed my umbrella. For the first time in all my 21 years, I was finally going to go out during a mega rainstorm. It was honestly a scary thought, and I was getting nervous. I opened the front door, and the first thing that hit me was the sound. The sound of the rain hitting the ground was so loud, it was like nothing I've heard before. I opened my umbrella and stepped out of my house, and immediately felt the weight and pressure of the water falling down on it. I could barely see anything outside the radius of my umbrella. The entire town seemed completely vacant. Everyone was inside, no cars on the road, no other people walking like I was. I slowly started making my way towards the street Sean was on, making sure I stayed on the sidewalk so that I wouldn't lose the street and get lost. It wasn't until I got about 4 blocks away from my house when I saw the dark outline of what appeared to be the figure of another person in the distance. They happened to be in the direction I was going, so I slowly started to get closer. And when I did, I could roughly make out that it was the figure of a man, a tall man. They didn't have an umbrella, and they weren't moving either. They were just standing there at the corner of the block. Once I finally got about 10 feet from the man, I saw that he was about 6.5 feet tall, and he wore a long black coat that went almost all the way down to his shoes. The collar of his coat was flared up so high, I couldn't see his face from the side. And atop his head, he wore a black fedora-style hat. I found it a bit weird that someone would even dare to come out in this storm without an umbrella. As I passed by the man, however, I noticed something that made me freeze. I couldn't see his face. There was nothing there but darkness. But possibly even just as disturbing was, despite the downpour, he was completely dry. The water looked like it was just rappelling right off his clothes, leaving him bone dry. The man didn't move or look at me at all as I slowly walked past him. I was freaked out, and I started to walk faster, trying to get away quickly. After I walked another block, I looked behind me, and the man was gone. I started wondering if I was just stressing out being in this rainstorm, and that it was anxiety getting to me. After walking a few more blocks, I started to calm down and dismiss the things I saw as being nothing more than just anxiety. And then I saw another figure walking the same direction I was, on the other side of the street. This person wasn't as tall, and they had an umbrella, so I knew it couldn't be the same man from before. I didn't pay them any mind as we both walked on opposite sides of the street from each other for another block or so. When I looked over at them this time, though, I saw a figure walking behind the person with the umbrella. It didn't take me long to recognize this familiar figure as the tall man from before. I was shocked. How could he have walked all the way here and caught up to us that quickly? I watched from the other side of the street as the tall man slowly got closer to the figure with the umbrella, until eventually, he was right behind them. It was then that the tall man in his dark coat reached out with both his arms and grabbed the person. He pulled them in tight. A large cloud of dark blue and black smoke enveloped them, and when the smoke dispersed, the tall man and the person were gone. The umbrella fell onto the ground with a clack as I stood there in disbelief. I started to think I was dreaming, and that this was just some sort of nightmare, but the occasional rain and wind hitting my face while under the umbrella reminded me that I wasn't dreaming. At this point, I was scared, and I started to walk faster and faster, just trying to get to Sean as quickly as I could. I only made it another block when I saw the tall, dark figure coming straight towards me on the same side of the road. Chills ran down my spine, and I immediately turned around and started running. By now, even with all the flood drains around, there was 2 or 3 inches of water across the whole street and sidewalk. This, combined with the rainfall, caused me to lose my footing. I fell down and got soaked as I lost grip of my umbrella. I looked back, and the dark figure was getting closer. I got to my feet and took off. After about a block, I saw an alleyway that had a roof and looked like a shortcut back to my neighborhood. I took it and was finally able to get out of the relentless downpour. Looking back at the tall man again, I noticed something else chilling. He appeared to be phasing in and out of reality, almost like he was teleporting a few feet at a time. No wonder he was catching up to me so quickly, even though he was only walking. He'd already made it into the alleyway I was taking. I saw him clearly walking through puddles and not making any ripples in the water at all. Whatever this tall, dark figure was, it was clearly not human. Somehow, I got past him, and I started to run back to my house, trying my hardest to not slip. When I exited the alleyway, I was relieved to see that I was only one block from my house. I looked back at the figure and noticed he was now closer than ever, only about 30 feet from me. Fearing for my life, I ran faster than I ever had, desperately trying to get back to my house, but the rain was making it hard to see. I was so tired and out of breath, I felt like I was going to pass out when I finally made it to my door. I ran inside and slammed the door shut and locked it. I took a deep breath, and then I looked out my living room window. I saw the tall man in his long dark coat and hat standing on the other side of the street. He was just standing there, staring at me, completely dry, like he was never out in the rain at all. Until the same large cloud of dark blue and black smoke covered him, and when it cleared, he was gone. I took another deep breath, still in shock over what I just experienced. I kept wondering, why didn't the figure grab me when I was so close to it? I must have been no more than 10 feet from him when I first got a good look at him. He could have easily grabbed me there, so why didn't he? Who was the person they grabbed a hold of earlier? What happened to them? I grabbed my phone and went to text Sean, but when I unlocked my phone, I saw something. A text from Sean, and it read, Hey, never mind. I actually found an umbrella in my glove compartment. I'm gonna try to walk and make my way to your house. See you in a bit. It was sent 10 minutes ago. I texted back telling Sean he needs to stay in his car and did not set foot out in this storm. I never got a reply. It's been 2 weeks now, and no one, including myself, has seen or heard from Sean at all. I went to the street and I found his car empty. A search was conducted to find him, but they were unsuccessful in finding any trace of him at all. I never told anyone about what happened to me out there and what probably became of my best friend, fearing people would think I was losing my mind. But I know. I know what really goes on out there during these storms. I know what really happened to Sean, and I miss him. I wish I could have seen that text sooner to warn him of the Rain Man.